Good morning, dear friends. We're going to continue to learn halachot of lashon hara. Hashem shall help us to create a positive life for ourselves and others, as Hashem created us with a certain body. We have body, and body by nature is negative, right? We have over 80,000 thoughts in our minds, and most of the thoughts that come into our head are negative. And we have to be constantly plugged into the positivity, constantly remind us that we're more than just our bodies, we're more than just negative tendencies in our brain. We are neshamas, we're holy souls, and we can learn halachot lashon hara and plug into that. Day 47 from Book Purity of Speech, it says a story about a shidduch that was broken the day after the engagement party, and the message was sent to the bride that the shidduch was broken because there was negative information revealed at the engagement party. The one of the guests had negative information about the bride, and because of that the engagement was closed. And the family couldn't understand who was it possible that would say something negative about the kala, about the bride. Years later, the truth emerged that at the engagement party, the mother of the bride, she was talking to her friend, and somebody overheard, the Khatan's family overheard, and the mother of the bride told her friend, "I hope the Khatan will be able to handle my daughter." That's all she said. She said, "I hope the Khatan will be able to handle my daughter." Little did she know that these words would break the engagement party. The shame, the anguish, the shattered dreams, all of the above can be terrible ramifications of lashon hara. Halacha in practice, about whom it's forbidden to speak lashon hara, family members. Like we said yesterday, you're not allowed to speak lashon hara about your children. So too, you're not allowed to speak lashon hara about any family members, your parents, your spouse, your in-laws, your siblings. And you can even not allowed to speak lashon hara you cannot discuss your children with the other family members. You cannot speak lashon hara to it's a suit to talk to lashon hara about family members, even to other family members, right? You cannot speak to your father or your mother about negative information about your children. You cannot say negative information, right, to your sister about your mother, for example, right? Just to remind ourselves that we are creators of our own life, and by speaking out negative information, we will create our own life, and we have effect on other people. If we think positive about other people, the people will turn more into the positive. If we're going to start thinking negative, the people will turn more to the negative side. The couple examples, for example, you're not allowed to say, "Do you know why I suffer from low self-esteem? Because my mother always put me down." Another example, "I don't like to move into my parents' home with my family. My father gets so agitated when my kids make the slightest noise." You're not allowed to speak about spouse and in-laws. For example, "My mother-in-law does not teach her children generosity. My husband is quite stingy." This is lashon hara about the mother-in-law and the husband. Right? Again, you're not allowed to speak about your siblings and your own children. You cannot say, "My 12-year-old son has a raging temper. My 10-year-old daughter fights with everyone in her school." Now, if somebody, just a disclaimer, if somebody does have a certain negative trait that they believe is the cause of their upbringing, for example, somebody has a low self-esteem, it is advisable to go to a therapist and to talk about it, or to open someone up and to vent to someone about it, and even more, if you don't do that, you're going to end up speaking lashon hara because you're going to have these negative feelings inside of us. So it's advisable to vent about it, to go to speak about it, and to deal with your issues so you don't speak lashon hara, you know, to get rid of the negativity in order to let the positivity live in our lives. Hashem should help us to bring positivity into our lives and bring positivity to people around us. God bless you all.